In the previous video, we've shown you how to move around an Inkscape. Now, we'll teach you how to create shapes. If we want to start creating shapes, we have to select a tool from the toolbox on the left of the screen. We'll start by drawing rectangles. In order to activate the rectangle tool, we select the blue square in the toolbox on the left. Whenever a specific tool is selected from the toolbox, two parts of the interface will always change accordingly. The first one being the mouse cursor, now showing us that we can draw rectangles, and the second one is the tool control bar on the top of the screen. We can now start drawing the rectangle by simply clicking the left mouse button and dragging it. And as long as our rectangle tool is activated, we can keep on drawing additional rectangles. There are a few control points on our shape that we can use to change it. We can use the square shape control points to resize our rectangle. And we can use the circle shaped ones to run over the corners. While we are resizing our rectangle, you might have already noticed that the values will change accordingly in the control box. There is a value for the width and the height, and one for the roundover. So whenever you want to design a rectangle with specific dimensions, you can enter these here. Right now the values are set to millimeters, so we have a rectangle that is 100 millimeters wide by 80 millimeters high and with a roundover radius of 20 millimeters. And these will also be the exact dimensions when we have cut our shape on the laser or vinyl cutter. The icon on the most right of the tool control box is usually a reset button. In this case, it will make the corners of our rectangle sharp again. In exactly the same way, we can draw circles and ellipses. Select the circle-shaped icon in the toolbar on the left, then click your left mouse button somewhere on the canvas and drag it until you have an ellipse with the desired shape. We can use the square-shaped handles to change the shape of our ellipse, while the round ones will adjust the start and ending point of the angle. This way we can create open ellipses that look like Pac-Man or pizza slices. Also note that each tool is going to remember the last settings you used. So if you generated a shape that looked like Pac-Man, when you try to draw the next ellipse, it will have the same settings and thus the same look. In the control box, we can manually enter the two values for the start and ending angle of the ellipse. With the two buttons, we can select whether we want a closed segment or an open arc. And again, the icon on the most right of the toolbox is the reset button, which will make sure that your shape is a closed ellipse again. You might have already noticed that it's not that easy to generate a perfect circle by simply clicking and dragging. You will always end up with an ellipse. If you want a perfect circle, the easiest way to achieve this is holding the control key while you're dragging it, and then it will snap to a perfect circle once you come close to it. In the circle menu, you don't have the option to enter dimensions. So if you want to draw a circle with a specific diameter, you have to go into the selection menu first, select it, and then enter the dimensions for the width and the height in here. If you enter the same dimension for the width as for the height, you will get a perfect circle with that diameter. Then there's also the option to generate stars and polygons. You can do this by clicking the star and polygon menu on the left. Again, left click and drag to generate your shape. And then you get a bunch of parameters you can change. First of all, we can choose whether we want a polygon or a star, how many corners it has, we have a spoke ratio, we can round over the tips of our star or polygon, and we can randomize it. If we get too crazy with these parameters, we might end up with something that doesn't look like a star or polygon at all. So that's where the reset button, which in this case is shaped like a brush, comes in handy. Note that when you are generating stars and polygons, using the handles do different things than using the parameters. Using the handles, we can drag the tips at an angle, which gives them the appearance of the teeth of a saw blade. The last objects that we are going to show you are the text objects. These are pretty straightforward. We just press the text object button on the left of the screen, And now the object box will change to something that looks familiar from text editing software. We just have to click somewhere on the screen now and we can start typing. And we can use the settings in the object box to change the size of our letters, the text style, and the font.